Hello, everyone, and welcome to this conversation about Boss Plus, government's newest investment instrument for all of us. And to help us understand what it is, how it works, why government has issued this instrument, how we can use it to boost our income, improve our finances, and help our country provide the economic, social, and environmental services from which each of us benefits, is government's senior advisor, Dr. Kevin Greenidge. Welcome, Dr. Greenidge.
Thank you, Noveline. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure. Let us start by first having you remind us, what is Boss Plus?
Let me start with BOSS. BOSS is Barbados Optional Savings Scheme. It was launched in July 2020, and it was an option given to public servants where they can get a portion of their salary as a bond, earning 5% over a four-year period. And that allowed them to save in an attractive instrument. It was deducted from your salary. BOSS Plus just takes that concept, similar bond, but widen it to the general population, to anyone. It's not tied to your salary. So that's the whole Boss Plus builds on Boss, which was quite successful at the time.
Why are we launching Boss Plus?
Well, for many reasons. First of all, there really a dire of investment instruments in the market now for average persons to invest in. Boss was very successful. So this offers individuals, financial institutions, anyone, corporates, here and abroad to invest in this. Secondly, in support of the BERP program, which is government general economic program, government, of course, would need financing. And what better way to get financing than to reward your Bajans, Barbadians, persons who would then invest into building the country.
Let us just reflect a little bit on BOSS. How successful was it? Remind us.
BOSS, which was launched in July 2020 and over 18-month period, public workers put in a portion of their salary, etc. We were hoping to get at least $5 million per month in terms of the contributions, and it was basically that. But 35% of those were taken up by public workers. The remainder was then taken up by the general public, financial institutions, pension funds, etc. So it achieved its purpose in terms of providing financing to government and also giving persons. And persons are getting interest in their accounts twice a year, January and July. So in that regard, it achieved its goal.
Dr. Greenidge, how much are you looking to raise from Boss Plus? And just share with us some of the finer details. You said it has an attractive interest rate. When do we get our interest? Just some details about Boss Plus.
All right, so the idea is that government will start to tap into the domestic market and try to rebuild that market and rebuild confidence in the market and provide instruments. So this first issuance for this fiscal year is $200 million. And you can buy amounts from $500 or more, whatever, anytime in the month.
That's
$500. $500, anytime in the end. It's a, what we say, instrument, a bond. So it's carrying interest rate of 4.5% over a five-year period. You ask them why you should invest it, but it makes sense. It's a good investment instrument. If you had $1,000, you put down $1,000 in it, then you would be getting 4.5%, which is $45 a year, paid in February and August. And so over the 5 years, you have gotten $225 on your $1,000. And in the fifth year, in the same month you put it down, you have gotten back your $1,000. So you come up with your $1,000 and $225. Now, you can compare to any instrument. Say, take an interest deposit in any bank. The average deposit rate is 0.14. It means that the same $1,000, you will earn $1.40 each year. Over the period, that's $7. And so you get $7 if you were in a financial instrument like a bank account. Unfortunately, I was checking the minimum I could see in terms of bank fees. Savings account carry at least $5. So that's $60 a year, $300 over the five-year period. So you're going to actually lose that. Now I'm not saying don't keep your money, some money in the bank for transactional other purposes. What I'm saying is that this is such an attractive instrument that it will make sense for the part of your investment portfolio and part of your savings portfolio. So again, 4.5% over a five-year period. What's other interesting about the bond? These bonds, like the BOSS bond, in the legislation says that they cannot be restructured. But I know there's been some talk about, well, you can change the association, etc. Truth be told, at the height of the debt restructuring was necessary in 2018, the savings bonds that were held by everyone, those were not restructured. The boss bonds and boss plus is a savings bond type instrument. So if debt were restructured when it was really a dire situation, there's no way that even if we were to find ourselves on that, that it would ever come along. I think this really is almost a risk-free as you can get instrument, which you should be investing in.
And of course, you're helping your country when you invest in BOSS Plus as well, because you're contributing to our social, economic, and environmental development. Just help our listeners understand what we mean when we say we're contributing to our development in those.
I think you said it perfectly, though. I don't know if I could say any better. The direct way you earn, you're going to gain. The 4.5%, that's direct. Every twice a year, you want to see the interest in your outcome. Indirectly, what you're doing is you're providing financing to government so that government can continue to build its economic program to help the country recover and grow. Some of the things you have seen with the new buses, improved garbage trucks, road construction starting. As the country builds out, economy start to grow, right? The individuals, you as yourself, helping your fellow worker, your neighbor, your aunt, your cousin, uncle, get employment, get jobs, and able to provide for themselves. So you're indirectly helping the nation, which helps you again, and you're directly helping yourself. It's a win-win. We all have a vested interest in seeing this country finally begin to grow.
You mentioned that these bonds will not be reprofiled or restructured, but is there any leeway for government to review the interest rate at any time in future issuances?
Right. So this issue, which is for this fiscal year, is $200 million. The government intention is bring perhaps a new issuance another fiscal year and continue to start to build the market, give persons things to invest. At that time, it will make sense to look at the interest rate, because 4.5% now may make sense given the profile that we just had BOSS before. There's some other instruments out there like the pandemic bond, and then there's some other bonds that were restructured. It will make sense. The next fiscal year, what the team will do is sit down and look at what interest rate makes sense in the market. And so there must be a way for the government to change interest rate from issue to issue. You don't want the same rate. And that will be the extent to which I think is modified. That is part of the legislation, I think, in the order paper. The procedure is basically the paper will go to Parliament for approval when that time comes.
What would you say to those skeptics, Dr. Greenidge, who believe that really government's debt is too high and we really should not be issuing new debt?
When we first started the BOSS program, around the May-June of 2018, debt was 176% of GDP. And government had over $1.9 billion in arrears. Today, at the end of July 2022, debt is 125% of GDP. And arrears are under 100, just $100 million or something like that. Government remains current all its obligations. The scenario, so debt is not a concern at the moment. I'm not concerned about debt. All governments borrow and retire. The plan is to have a debt profile that is sustainable, that you can pay. And if the economy grow, the same investment you're talking about, we're helping to grow, that will help to grow the economy to provide more space for government, we say debt space or fiscal space, to do more in the economy. So this, you cannot, there's no way, our debt now cannot be compared before. Yes, it is still high, but remember, we always look at debt as a ratio to GDP income in the country. Our income contracted because of a pandemic by 14%. As that grow, that debt ratio will come down. I must also tell you that the government has a debt management team in the Ministry of Finance, a debt unit, and an overall debt technical working group. So every debt instrument we issue go through a thorough analysis, capacity repair, impact on future borrowings in terms of debt repayments, and make sure it's a smooth profile out, right? So we just don't say, okay, we borrow. There's a full analysis going to. So that is not a concern at the moment in terms of inability to pay or being too high. It is high, and we have a path for it to come down.
Remind us now why it is important that we build a domestic investment market.
Well, for a number of reasons, Nolene. First off, some economic management will require you not to put all your debt in foreign debt, because at the end of the day, you have to find foreign dollars, US dollars, whatever currency, to pay that debt, right? So you want some, but the majority usually should be your domestic debt, because one, you're paying first in local currency. Two, you're offering citizens a chance to make an earning on their investment and participate in building the country. So it's a win-win for that. But the major point is that you don't want the larger portion of your debt to be foreign, because then you could possibly put pressure on your reserves to pay those. Now, I must say, your reserve at $3.1 billion, or roughly $3 billion now, when we do the math, it's like almost 7-8 times what would be required to pay our debt service. So it's not an issue that, but explaining clearly that you don't want that. So, and to be specific, right now, we have like our debt is like two-thirds is local and a third is foreign. And we want to build the local market now again.
Why should all of us invest in Boss Plus?
Because it's a win-win situation. You earn a savings instrument. You get a savings type instrument that earns you an attractive interest rate. But at the same time, you are doing almost, let's say, a patriotic duty, where you're helping your country to provide finance so that other people can get employment, etc.
Have you bought Boss Pluses yet, Dr. Greenidge?
No, really. I invested in the first Boss bond, and I'm still seeing interest twice a year. I check for it on July, and I check for it in January. And these bonds were issued on the 1st of September, I perhaps one of the first people to sign up. It's an amazing and attractive investment opportunity. And so if I want to be part of it. So I've already, I took my check to the central bank, and now I have a portion. And every month, as long as I can find extra savings, I will do that.
Thank you so much, Dr. Greenidge. It was an absolute delight having this conversation.
Thank you, Novin. Pleasure being here.
Before we wrap, we have a gentleman who's already indicated that he too will buy Boss Plus. He's Quinn Weekes, a data scientist and financial economist. We were discussing another matter when the issue of Boss Plus came up, and Quinn said that he would definitely investing in this security. So I asked him if he would share why he plans to buy Boss Plus. Hi, Quinn. How are you?
Hi, Noveline. I'm doing great. How about you?
I am well, thank you. Tell us, Quinn, why are you going to be buying Boss Plus?
Well, to be honest, when it comes to managing my finances these days to gain some passive income, traditional instruments such as savings or fixed instruments aren't really passing my benchmark. And if I decide to be a bit more active, the stock market is very volatile these days. And if I look to the crypto market, one day the prices are up and then the next day there's a huge crash. So it's very unpredictable. Now here comes Boss Plus, one of the most predictable instruments I've ever come across. It matures in 5 years, has an annualized interest rate of 4.5%, and I get semi-annual interest payments, meaning that I get these payments 2 times a year. Now, the best thing about Boss Plus is that after the 5 years and they're going to cash out my money, I don't have to pay a cent to government. And better yet, it's protected from any of government restructuring. Now, if I had an emergency or I wanted to cash out to just make a purchase, I could sell it to Bob down the road or to someone else on the secondary market that's interested. And if I held it for at least 24 months, I can cash it out at the central bank without any penalties. And again, it's tax-free. Now, let me show you guys exactly what I'm talking about.
Yes, give us an illustration.
So we're going to compare Boss Plus to some typical and traditional instruments. So let's say we were looking at our regular savings. Well, you know, in fact, savings are these days below 1% annually. So let's not even look at that. Let's look at something that's a bit more familiar to Boss Plus. let's look at like a fixed security. So if we had a fixed instrument that pays us 2.5% annualized for 5 years, if I place $500 into this instrument, at the end of 5 years, I'm going to earn interest equals $62.50. Now, if I put $5,000 it'll be 10 times that amount. So I'll get $625. Or we could look at this as a total return of 13%. Now, let's look at Boss Plus. Boss Plus has an annualized interest rate of 4.5% and a maturity of 5 years. If I put the same $500 into Boss Plus, at the end of 5 years, I would have been paid a total of $112.50 in interest. If I placed $5,000, over the 5 years, I would have earned $1,125 in interest, or 23%. Now, here are some other benefits with regards to the Boss Plus. Now, we looked at the fixed security, and it returns 13% if we invest $5,000, but this 13% is probably subject to fees and taxes. Whereas when we look at the Boss Plus, this 23% is exactly what you get. If you put in $5,000, you're going to get the $1,125. Now, the great thing about it is that you also have semi-annual payments. So let's say you put in this $5,000, on an annual basis, you will actually get $225 paid to you in two installments every 6 months.
Thank you so much, Quinn, for that illustration. Boss Plus is indeed a plus for our finances. And let me also thank Dr. Kevin Greenidge, who joined us earlier in the conversation and explained why he thought we should buy Boss Plus. For more information, visit the Central Bank's website at www.centralbank.org.bb. See you.